Hi dear friends, I welcome you once again to our G-Square Maths channel. Today in this video we are going to continue our mathematical fallacies. Two videos have already been posted. This is the third one. It's regarding geometry. As in the previous video, I told you that by wrong proof, that's called mathematical fallacies. By concealing a fact, by hiding a fact, by hiding a mathematical fact, by proving something wrong. But we will not find out where we went wrong it is. That's the beauty of the mathematical fallacies. You have to find out. By finding the mathematical fallacies mistakes, we can strengthen our concepts of mathematical concepts. So my dear children, please come again. Here what I'm going to do that, I'm going to prove a very surprising result. Every triangle is an equilateral triangle. And every triangle is an isosceles triangle also. Once every triangle is an isosceles triangle, automatically it is an equilateral triangle also. It will come as a corollary. So, let us see how we are going to prove that. So, for proving this, two, three facts which you already studied, let me quote it. In center of a triangle, we know that point of intersection of three angular bisectors. In a triangle ABC, A, B, C are three angles. The angular bisector of three angles are intersecting at the point E, that is called the incenter of the triangle. What is the beauty of the incenter? With that a center, when this perpendicular to the any one of the sides as radius, if you draw a circle inside the triangle, which it touches all the three sides. That's the incenter. Whereas, the circumcenter of a triangle is the point of intersection of three perpendicular bisector of the sides of the triangle. So, ABC is a triangle. AB is a side, BC is a side, AC is a side. Three sides we can draw the perpendicular bisector. What is the perpendicular bisector? The perpendicular drawn at the midpoint of the line segment of the side. BC is the line segment. D is the midpoint. Draw the perpendicular. That is a perpendicular bisector. This three perpendicular bisector also will intersect at one point. That point is called the circumcenter. What is the beauty of the circumcenter? With that as a center and the radius with some radius, if you draw a circle, that circle will pass through all the three vertices. In center, in circle will touch the three sides inside the triangle, whereas the circumcircle will pass through all the three vertices of the triangle. Okay, now let's come back. So what is that's a property, and this is a real fact definition I'm telling that. And ABC is a line segment. Let's see the midpoint of it. Draw the perpendicular. The property says, take any point on the perpendicular and join this. This will be equal always. Taken any point on the perpendicular bisector, if you join that to the two ends of the line segment, that side will be equal. The proof is very simple. As is the perpendicular, this is perpendicular, one angle, and this is this one, and one side. By RHS property, right angle, hypotenuse, side, these two triangles are congruent. Therefore, these two are equal. So, taking any point on the take, this that also I am going to apply here. Another thing one I am going to apply here to prove this, an angle, this is an angular bisector. Take any point on the angular bisector, the leg means the perpendicular drawn from that point to the arms of the angle. This is AB is an AB and AC are the arms of the angle A. I draw a perpendicular angular bisector of the angle A. Take any point on that. This perpendicular will always be equal. That's how the proof is very simple. This is 90 degree, this is 90 degree. This is angle bisector, therefore these two are equal. This is common. Two triangles are congruent triangles. And hence, this is equal. These two properties I'm going to apply here. Okay. Now, how I am going to prove this? ABC is a triangle. What is given? ABC is a triangle. That's all. It may be any triangle. A scalene triangle. All the three sides are not equal. So, that triangle, I am going to prove that is an isosceles triangle. So, it is enough for me if I prove that AB is equal to AC. Two sides, if I prove that is equal, then I can say that the triangle is an isosceles triangle. Okay. So, let me consider this triangle, right angle triangle. Sorry, before that I have to explain the figure. ABC is a given figure and AE is the angular bisector of this angle A. This is an angular bisector. Therefore, the property what I explained is that E is a point on that, this two will be equal. Similarly, this is DE is a perpendicular bisector and E is a point on the perpendicular bisector. Therefore, this two will be equal. That's what I explained this concepts. So, by that property, ABC is a triangle given, construction, draw the perpendicular angular bisector of angle A and draw the perpendicular bisector of side BC. Let it intersect at the point E. Draw a perpendicular. That's my construction. I'm coming to the proof. Now, in triangle, AGE and triangle AFE. These two triangles. This angle is 90 degree. This angle is also 90 degree. First one, this one. And by construction, it is the angular bisector. Therefore, these two sides, these two angles are equal. Two angles are equal. And this is a common side. Therefore, by angle, side property, criteria of a congruent triangles, these two triangles are congruent triangles. Let me repeat once again. But after this construction, I consider these two triangles. I am proving these two triangles are congruent triangles. How I am proving this? I am taking the congruency property, angle side. This angle equal, this is 90 degree equal, this is a common side. So, therefore, the two triangles are congruent triangles. Therefore, this implies if two triangles are congruent triangles, all sides are equal. All angles are also equal. Therefore, AG is equal to AF. Equation 1. Similarly, consider the triangle EGB and triangle EFC. These two triangles, EGB and EFGC, these two triangles are considering. I am going to prove that these two triangles are also congruent. How am I going to prove that? Okay. So, this is perpendicular equal. Why it is equal? This is the angular bisector. A point is taken. The leg is a perpendicular to the arms. These two are the arms. I am drawing a perpendicular from the point on the angular bisector. That two should be equal. These two are equal. And similarly, these two are equal. Why these two are equal? This is a perpendicular bisector. From the perpendicular bisector, if you take any point on that, join the extremities of the line segment, that two will be equal. So, these two are equal. This side is equal. This side is equal. And this angle is 90 degrees. This is 90. Therefore, by RHS property, that two triangles are congruent triangles. Hope it is clear. Now, as these two are equal, this implies GB is equal to FC. Sides are equal. As these two triangles are congruent, this side is equal to this side. Right? Okay. Now add 1 and 2. 8G plus GB is nothing but AB. AF plus FC is equal to AC. What is given? ABC is a triangle only given. I proved that AB is equal to AC. A funny result. Any triangles need not be isosceles triangle. Any triangle need not be equilateral triangle. But I proved it. That means I did something or manipulate something or without you knowing that where I went wrong, I proved that that is. Now it is your duty that you have to find out where I went wrong. Right? Okay. So, in the same way, by drawing an angular bisector and opposite the perpendicular bisector, you can prove that BC is equal to AC also. This is another corollary to this. I proved that AB is equal to AC, that is an isosceles triangle, proof is over. Now I am coming. How to prove that any triangle is an equilateral triangle? Equilateral triangle means all the three sides are equal, I have to prove that. I already proved that these two are equal. Similarly, by drawing a same construction, angular bisector and perpendicular bisector from this side, I can prove that BC is equal to AC. So, ABC equal to BC, but BC is equal to AC. Hence, three sides are equal. Therefore, any triangles are congruent triangles. So, my dear children, there is something where I went wrong. This is a fact you have to find out. Please find out and post this in our comments. Then I will come back to you. If you like this, please subscribe and share. Thank you.